Well, meanwhile, in Bangladesh, have hammered out a timeline for repatriating hundreds of thousands of Rohingya Muslims. 650,000 Rohingya fled a brutal military crackdown in Myanmar, seeking refuge in Bangladesh. Many are now at one of the world's biggest refugee camps in Cox's Bazar. Both countries released details of the plan Tuesday. Let's break that down for you. It calls for the return of Rohingya refugees to Myanmar within the next 2 years. Bangladesh will set up 5 transit camps. The Rohingya will go from the transit camps to reception centers in Myanmar. This plan applies only to Rohingya who fled Myanmar after October 2016. The UN estimates 200,000 Rohingya were already in Bangladesh before that date. The repatriation process is set to start next Tuesday. Kevin Allen is with the UN Refugee Agency. He's the head of emergency operations for the Rohingya refugee crisis at Cox's Bazar in Bangladesh, and he joins us now. Kevin, thank you so much for being with us. Let me start right off the bat by getting your thoughts on this deal. Do you have concerns? What do you make of the way it's been formulated?
Well, actually, I think there's a few things that I would emphasize at the outset. And the first thing is that the voice of the refugees need to be central to any decision on returns. The second thing that I would emphasize is any return needs to occur in conditions that are safe, that are voluntary, and ultimately that are sustainable. Now, Aisha, when we've spoken with the refugees here in Bangladesh, these 655,000 refugees who've crossed the border since 25 August, they have essentially set forth 3 preconditions from their perspective to return. The first is that the government of Myanmar needs to address the issue of citizenship and legal status. The second is that they need to be able to return in conditions of safety. It's got to be a safe place to go back to. And the third is there need to be reconstruction efforts to ensure that they're able to enjoy their basic rights when they do go back home. Now, typically, UNHCR, when we engage in these types of scenarios, would enter into an agreement between the government of Myanmar, the government of Bangladesh, and UNHCR to ensure that, number one, we give voice to the refugees, and number two, that we ensure that any returns occur in line with international standards. What does that mean? That they're voluntary, that they're safe, that they're sustainable. Now, in the current context, the two governments have opted to enter into a bilateral agreement. This agreement was initially signed in November. Now, UNHCR, the UN Refugee Agency, is contemplated in that agreement, but we have not been party to the discussions that have occurred to date, including discussions in Myanmar on the 15th of January. So UNHCR is keen to engage with both governments, the government of Myanmar, the government of Bangladesh, to ensure that there's a framework that ensures any returns occur in line with international standards.
I mean, the obvious question is why UNHCR was not brought in right at the outset of the construction of this deal. And furthermore, as you talk about the 3 conditions that are necessary for a successful repatriation of these refugees, at this set, do you see any signs of the government there in Myanmar trying to rebuild and to patch the mistrust that exists between the Rohingya and the authorities?
Well, there are a couple of things that I would note. The first is if you understand the spirit, but also the text of the agreement between the two governments, not only is UNHCR contemplated, but international standards, return that's voluntary, that's safe, sustainable, are contemplated. So the key at this stage is that we are able to continue our dialogue, to be part of the discussion between the two states, so that we can achieve a framework that is in line with international standards and that critically gives voice to the refugees. This is a complex situation. We are encouraged that the two states are engaging in dialogue, in a conversation. We would like to be part of that conversation. So on the one hand, we can ensure that international standards are met, that returns are voluntary, that they're safe. But on the other hand, to ensure that the voice of the refugees are heard. Now, I mentioned that the refugees have essentially said there are 3 preconditions from their perspective to return. The first is that the citizenship issue and legal status is resolved. The second, that they can go back home in a condition that's safe. And the third, that they're able to go back home in an environment where there's been reconstruction efforts, where they can enjoy their basic rights and services. Now, it's interesting to note that these 3 requirements of the refugees are very much in line with the recommendations of a commission that was led by the former Secretary General Kofi Annan, the Rakhine Advisory Commission report, which has been endorsed by the government of Myanmar. So I think it is incumbent as UNHCR, but also the international community, to encourage the government of Myanmar to implement those recommendations as quickly as possible so that the conditions for return are there. Because ultimately, UNHCR's hope, the hope of most refugees around the globe, is that one day they're able to go back home. We all want to be at home, but that can only occur if it's voluntary and if it occurs in conditions of safety and dignity.
Yeah, without a doubt, that is what is most needed here. Kevin Allen, head of UNHCR's emergency operations, we thank you for joining us and giving us the important context. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Asha.